Hi folks, welcome to CIT 400 summer 2021. We've left quite a few interesting semesters behind us, and I can say with this course, I look through the lens of you're working on one more course in the summer, and this is a path to your graduation once you have this done. Okay, so a little bit about myself. Again, I'm Dr. Carol Marcotte. You've seen that on the instruction list. And I actually work in the education department, and I work in schools with undergraduate and graduate students. I have taught this course face-to-face a few times to support Sam McReynolds when he needs someone. And I've also taught this course the last two summers. So it's shorter than what it is when you're in the classroom, and I'll get into that in a little bit. So again, Sam McReynolds is the one that's in charge of the course, and there's a couple of things I'll allude to as I go through class one with you. So the best way to share what's going on in this class is to share the syllabus with you and a little bit about Blackboard. You know Blackboard, you've been on it. We haven't changed to Brightspace yet, so let me show you just the setup of this course, and I will screen share. And let's get rid of that. So here's the course, pretty much, I'm sure you're used to the setup. Here's the welcome, it's the syllabus. This is site database of some of the places that you can look in this area to do your service that you need to do for the course. Course materials, and again, I'll just briefly show you all the articles, all the documentation that you need to do is in here. And then as you can see, we have five classes. Class four, we will have a debate. So now I will go to, let me just open this up a little bit more. I want to keep that back screen for you though. So as we start off, you see there's no text. There is the database, as I shared with you. It's a pass-fail course. You know that. You have to get 70 points to pass. And so class participation, there are five classes, and each class has a discussion board. You're to write about the articles that you had to read or the videos, and then you have to also respond to a peer, all right? In a nutshell, that's what it is. Civic engagement proposal. I want to stop for a moment. I'm not doing this fast to do it fast. I'm doing it because I value your time. Okay, you can go back and look at the syllabus yourself later for totality reasons. So you have to have a civic engagement proposal. You have to go out there and have a civic engagement project where you work with folks for service, basically. So the proposal is in class one. I'll show you that in a moment. Criteria is there, 10 points. Criteria is here as well. Okay, and this is what the proposal should include. You submit that. I accept it, more than likely will accept it. If there's something that you just, that's not your in your wheelhouse of doing in that list, and you have something that you're working on right now, use that as service. Don't reinvent the wheel. I don't want you doing double duty for things. Okay, so think about that. A couple of people have already emailed me or texted me, and I have also approved, even though it wasn't in that list. If you can't get out and do a civic project, which I'm hoping you can, let me know. We'll work through that. And then you have to attend one. It's usually more than one. Summer, one civic engagement community event. It could be a board meeting. It could be a city council, 10 points in the criteria. This is the biggie. And actually, this is going to change to 35 points because at the very end, we're going to do a reflective essay. It's always in the course. And what I do when I'm in class or when we do it online, that last module, you're going to brainstorm together to help you complete this paper. Okay, so why is that 35 points instead of 40? Because I'm going to share that in a moment. How's that? So it talks about your civic engagement and then on goes all the other pieces that we need to have in a syllabus. And there are some diversity pieces that are in here this semester. So what I'm gonna do is save that. There has just been a change on that. So, and I will put that in the course when you get there. How's that? So let's go to class one. And this is where the change has come. I alluded to Sam McReynolds a little while ago. He would really like to have us do the debate, class four, in a Zoom situation. I've already sent out a link. Many of you completed that link. I thank you so much. I apologize for having to make you do this again, but that's the ultimate, to do the debate via Zoom. So we're looking for a common time. If that doesn't work, it's going to be through a discussion board. So let's get to plan A first. This here now is 5 points. It's actually an assignment. So I took the 5 points off the final so you could get points for completing this. Class one is an introduction. And here's your CIT proposal. It tells you where you can find that information. And it's an assignment. And this is where you complete it, okay? All of this, if you could do the doodle as soon as you can, I would so appreciate it. The course actually opens up tomorrow. And then we go to class two. But you can see the dates, 5/17 to 5/24. By 5/23/24, you have to have these assignments done before you go into class two, okay? Have any questions, feel free to text me. My phone number is 207-284-3680. All my undergrads, grads text me all the time. If you have a question, I wanna respond to it. My email is cmarcotte@une.edu. You have any questions, please let me know. I am sure I've forgotten a zillion things, but most importantly, be well. Enjoy your summer as much as you can. Ooh, and I'll stop, I'm sorry. I'll stop sharing. Enjoy your summer as much as you can. And let's get this done, okay? All right. I appreciate everything that you do. You're UNE students. Let's go. Thank you.